Show. This is share this video. Yeah. Yeah. Can't depend on no one else. Woo. Hey. Please share this video, you guys. Cause I need a little help, so I can't help myself. You gotta believe, but you got the power, y'all. Every hour, when you can't have no one else, yeah. You got to believe.
Hold on, everything will be alright. amazing is what I needed. This is Ann Fry, host of the Yams Talk Show. Welcome tonight to this special edition of the Yams Talk Show, where I decided, since I can't do the live show anymore until we get through this trying, perilous time that we are in right now with this situation called the coronavirus, that I will take the next few weeks and do some poetry, because for those of you who don't know, I am a spoken word artist. I write my own material. I started doing spoken word back in 1997 or 1998 down at Sidewalk University when I first discovered my beautiful gift of words. Well, I had discovered that I had the gift of words, but not poetically and not as an author. I used to just write for my church and write plays and skits and all types of things back then. But so I do spoken word. I'm also a comedian. I also am a motivational speaker, for those of you who don't know. And some people know me as either or. Some people only know me as a comedian. Some people only know me as a talk show host. Some people only know me as an author, that I am the author of the inspirational books titled You Are My Sister. Some people know me as a motivational speaker. What I've learned about the gift, and I'm sharing with you, is that if you just use one gift, you'll discover that you have so many more. And that is truly what has happened to me. I keep adding all of these, I call it promotions, because I am the CEO of FIG Productions, and publishing is what I am today, and a talk show host and all those things. But I just wanted to share Amphora with you guys, because I'm always interviewing everybody else. I am supporting and uplifting everybody else and interviewing them. I want you to know who I am, because Amphora knows who she is. Yes, I do. Took me a long time to get there, and I am currently completing my autobiography. I put that out there, the mock-up for the book. I'm just a few pages away from the first draft of the manuscript itself. I have my editor, Ms. Maxine Thompson, out in LA. We're going to be working on it together to get it out to you by fall, or whenever this virus ends. I'll be having pre-sales. But I have been blessed, you guys, with the gift of words. I walk in my gift. As my friend Princeton Ethel says, I operate in my gift today. And I'm sharing that with you because it is important to know how to operate in your gift. And when you operate and live and walk in your gift, opportunities that are already there that you didn't realize will come to you, so that the world and the universe will make you room for your gift. So I'm going to do poetry tonight. I'm going to do part one. And then next Sunday, I'll do part two, because I have so much poetry. Some of it is in my books, You Are My Sister. Some of it God has given me in the last few weeks, in the last few years. And I haven't been able to get out and perform poetry like I would like to. Like I first got started, I was doing it every week at Precious Cargo, Sidewalk University, University of Memphis, at different other spots around town. I love performing. I am an actor too, you know. I keep adding titles to what I do, but I love that I have been blessed with the gift of words. So tonight I'm going to do a few pieces for you tonight. I'll do a piece, and then after I finish, you can comment. I'll read your comments before we go to the next piece. I'm going to be doing probably about 6 or 7 of my original writings. I really don't perform anyone else's poetry, unless I do something that was written by Maya Angelou in honor of her, but I do my own. I write my own poetry. I write my own spoken words, truthfully. It is a ministry, honestly. So I want to say hi to the people who have signed on already. Ask that you please share this video. Hi, Judy, Michigan, yes. Oh, my dad is watching, you guys. Thank you guys for your prayers. My sister Pamela says, Dad is watching. He said I did not know Ann could sing. Y'all, he probably doesn't. He didn't know I could do a lot of things. Thank you, Pamela. Hi, my daughter, Samantha, my godchild. She says, I want you to write my story. I'm going to help you write your own story. Is what FIG Publishing is getting ready to do, help people to write their own stories. Let's see who else I can see. I can't always see everything. My son Cameron is watching from Alaska. I love you, Cameron. I love Kay. Thank you, guys. Please share this video. The first piece that I'm going to do tonight is so appropriate. I wrote it back in probably, hi, Judy. I wrote this back in probably 97. It is simply titled Blessed. And I hope that you guys know and feel and live a life, no matter what's going on in the world. I hope this connects to you and you feel this way, because I've been feeling this way truthfully my whole life. I might get a little emotional, but this piece is titled Blessed. When I think about my problems, my ups and downs and crazy turnarounds, and I'm feeling a little depressed, I think of children starving, being abused, or having so much less. I realize that no matter what I've been through, my life has truly been blessed. When my heart is broken and I'm feeling sad and lonely or under a lot of stress, I think about children dying, being in pain and feeling distressed. Within minutes, I realize that no matter what I've been through, my life has truly been blessed. When I feel that life has dealt me a terrible hand, I want to give up because I've had more than I can stand. I realize that without me, how empty this world would be. For my son Cameron and Cade and my entire friends and family, I realize that what I was feeling was only a test to make me understand that through it all, my life has truly been blessed. Thank you, guys. I hope you are feeling blessed today in spite of coronavirus. I hope you are feeling blessed today, no matter what you're going through, if you've been abused, if you've been used, if you've been whatever it is. If you are watching today, I want you to know that you are blessed, you guys. You are blessed. I am blessed. And blessed just means that you got up this morning. You got another opportunity to make a difference, to change your life, to do something with your life, to help somebody. That is what being blessed is. It's really not even about you. It's about what you can do and how you can make a difference. And if I can do it with my life, you can too, because you and I, we are both blessed. Yes, thank you. That's a piece I wrote a long time ago. We're doing a few more. Hi, Gloria. She says, I love it. Hi, Angela. Thank you. Angela Winton Phillips, thank you. Thank you so much. I am blessed. I live a blessed life, but I'm not one to go around talking about, oh, I'm so blessed and highly favored. I just walk and live my truth. When you live your truth, you don't have to go around saying that you're highly favored and blessed. You just live the life that God has given you to live. And that is what I do. That is who I am. I am Amphra Boyd, and I am blessed. Yes, I am. Hi, Natasha. That was a beautiful piece. Thank you. This next piece I'm going to do, I'm trying to think. I had it all outlined, but I have to let the spirit tell me how to do things in the moment that I'm doing it. The next piece I'm going to do is titled Mother Earth, because we live in this time now, this coronavirus, I believe that it was divinely ordered. We had to get something to get us to be still, you guys. something is wrong in the world and in the earth. And I wrote this piece back in 2011 for Earth Day. I'm going to be doing a video coming up soon with me performing this piece about Mother Earth. And like a lot of women who've been abused, myself included, we all are abusing Mother Earth. Mother Earth. For generations, Mother Earth has been in a perpetual abusive relationship with mankind. She has been violated, raped, pimped, and prostituted for her precious jewels, oil, water, and natural resources. Her soul has been contaminated, her oxygen polluted, her spirit suffocated, her beauty beaten and battered beyond belief. Her womb poisoned, and she can no longer produce her natural fruits. Her rivers, lakes, and oceans are filled with toxic waste, no longer pure. Her heart no longer beating, her lungs no longer breathing, her soul no longer living. Now she is confused and dying while she's crying out for help. Her seasons no longer know when to change. 1 minute the sun shines, 1 minute it rains. Snow falls in warm regions, cold places experience extreme heat. Mother Earth is trying to fight back, but she wants to declare defeat. Her anger and rage creates hurricanes, tsunamis, and typhoons. She prays to the sun and the moon for help, asking God to forgive her abusers, those ungrateful users who continue to abuse her. Her fear of dying makes her extremely mad, and she starts to violently shake, producing tornadoes, strong winds, and massive earthquakes. Now it's time for mankind to stop the abuse, stop killing our mother, and show her that we love her and need her love to stay alive. We need Mother Earth's love, wisdom, and nourishment to continue to live our lives. Without Mother Earth, y'all, we all are gonna die. Yes, we are. We abuse Mother Earth. Thank you. That piece came to me during the, in 2011, when it was so much flooding going around down south and throughout the country. It came to me also a little bit of it in 2000. I think it was 3 or 5 with the tsunami and the when the that ship lost all that oil on all the waters, you guys. We are abusing Mother Earth, you guys. We are physical beings created from the earth, spirits that came from the universe to experience life in the human way on earth, and we are abusing the very ground, the very dirt that we're gonna go back to. We even poison Mother Earth when we are buried. We're so full of chemicals. Our graveyards are abusing Mother Earth today. Yes, it is, you guys. And I'm spiritual. I see things spiritually. I see things differently. I see things the way God has given the vision to me. And this is how it comes out poetically. Mother Earth, you guys, thank you. Thank you. That piece is special to me because when I see, I'm Native American. I am a Native American. My dad, Mr. Leroy Boyd, who is watching, his side of the family, they are Cherokee Indians, and they preserve the earth. They, the Native Americans, what Columbus called Indians, they worshiped the sun and the earth because they knew that they needed them to live and to survive. And here we are in 2020, we don't honor either one. We don't take care of ourselves or the Mother Earth that has given our lives birth. Amen. Okay, let's see, let's read some more here. Who's on here? Tawanda Carson says, hey, Amber. Hey, Kate Cutter. Thank you. Cynthia Dorch, my sister, says, wow, so much passion. Mother Earth, powerful. Samantha says, thank you for tuning in. Thank you, guys. Hi, Vanessa Barton. Hi. Hi, you guys. That was Mother Earth. The next piece I'm going to do, I just wrote about maybe, I think I wrote this piece in 2014, maybe before I moved home to Memphis. I was still living in Eastern Michigan, right outside of Detroit. I posted it on my page. I'm going to be filming it as well. When I released my new book, I'll have a whole poetry CD and videos to go with them. I am conscious, you guys. I'm no longer religious. I'm no longer Christian. I'm not any other religion. I live by the Spirit of God that is within me. And he gave me this piece to write. I write in the Spirit. Sometimes when I finish writing and I read what I wrote, I'm like, who wrote that? I didn't say that. Those are not my words, but they are inspired by God. And it's because I'm conscious. This piece is called How to Control the Masses. I want you to just think about that. How to Control the Masses. The artist Prince Rogers Nelson, when he was in his turmoil with Warner Brothers Records, the entertainment industry, he wrote, if you don't own your masters will own you. And I think I got that idea maybe when I read that years ago and listened to him talk about how he had all of these master recordings of his original music, yet he did not own the copyright to them, and that his masters, the people who owned him, was Warner Brothers. And this is so apropos because he said, if you don't own your masters will own you. So I wrote this piece called How to Control the Masses. The objective of our capitalist society is to control the masses, implement rules, religions, and regulations to control the world population, govern their food, their health, their shelter, their water, and education to ensure that the wealthy have complete world domination. Give the masses the illusion of inclusion into the superficial world of delusion. Fill their lives with expensive distractions, seduce them with video games of sex and violence. To ensure they are distracted, get the masses addicted to technology and electronic devices. Take away their innate ability to think logically, critically, and consciously about the death and destruction of their own human bodies and the social ills plaguing our society. Once you control their minds, their souls will follow. Their spirits will become empty and hollow, and the masses will then follow the evils of society deemed normal. Lies become truth. Men become women, and women become men. And yet, this is only the beginning of the worst kind of institutionalized religion, the religion of greed, violence, and self-destruction brought on by voluntary each and every one of us. Yes. The control of the masses is the new form of slavery, the illusion of wealth, status, and celebrity, when in reality, we all live in poverty without the sovereignty and the power and knowledge of one's own self, self-worth, self-control, and self-actualization. We've surrendered our power to the elite and accepted the defeat of conquering and controlling our own health, wealth, and destiny. Oh, yes. How to control the masses by using religion, finances, and ethnicity to divide the masses spiritually, keep them arguing, debating, which leads to fighting and killing because none of them are willing to not judge, but educate and learn from each other that together we all cohabitate on God's green earth. How to control the masses? Seduce them with convenience. Make everything quick and easy. Make them lazy and impatient, no longer conscious, living their lives without respect, empathy, and compassion. To control the masses, make them believe that they no longer need to think. make them reliant and dependent on external sources to supply and fulfill their every want and need. Make them spend all of their money on name brands and material possessions, which would fill their lives with artificial and superficial happiness to disguise their spiritual emptiness and lack of moral consciousness. Oh, yes. The media controls the masses with fashions and trends and subliminal addictions. And soon, no one will pay attention and listen to spiritual and conscious words of wisdom. Yes, my name is Ephra. And just so you know it, I am a conscious poet. Thank you. I love that piece. Thank you. We are under control, you guys. We are under so much control. We're more enslaved than our ancestors who were beaten and whipped and robbed and raped. We are more enslaved in 2020 than ever before in history because we have the illusion of freedom. The illusion of freedom. Yes, we do. That was how to control the masses. You guys, I want you to think. It's not that I want you to think. Learn to think for yourself. Educate yourself. That's what I did. When the internet came about 20 some years ago and I got it at home, I used it to educate myself. I still do. The first thing I did back then, it wasn't Google. I was on America Online. The first thing I searched was who was King James. Finding out who King James was and Constantine and all of those white people over in Europe and what they had taught and beat my people into believing changed my life, y'all. And I said, okay, I can't do this no more. I have to live an authentic life. I have to know God for myself. I've got to learn how to connect and create to my creator, you guys. And I'm standing here living proof, living proof that it is possible that we've been lied to, and we are under so much control. We are still enslaved. Thank you. Oh my God, Ron Wainwright, author, my friend in Detroit says, go girl. Angela Witten Phillips says, says yes. And Ron says, new book, yes. Yes, the new book is titled The Gift of Words. It is my life story. I've made a lot of mistakes in my life. I've done a lot of things in my life. I'm still gonna make some mistakes in my life. I've loved the wrong men in my life. I've been abused in my life, you know? And so I'm telling it, I'm leaving nothing on the table in the gift of words and hope that it will help somebody else to understand that until you believe in you, it doesn't matter what anyone else thinks of you or believes about you. Until you find your voice. When you find your voice, you find your strength, you find your power, you find your purpose, your passion, and all of that leads to prosperity, you guys. Maybe not riches and celebrity, because prosperity, it should be measured by how you can make a difference in this world. That is what prosperity is to me. So thank you guys. That was called How to Control the Masses. Angela Winston Phillips says, that was awesome. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Please share this video, you guys. Please, please share this video. Thank you for those who've already shared it, but please share it. The next piece I want to do is from my new book. I wrote this piece when I lived in Inkster, Michigan, or Novi. I was living in Detroit, whatever I did. Hi, Jamil, the diva. Hi, how you doing? This next piece I'm going to do is actually called The Gift of Words. And I have the gift. No matter what form of words I need to use, but whether, you know, poetry, writing, speaking, writing books, movies, whatever it may be, I have the gift of words. And that is what this piece is titled. I performed it a lot while I was in Detroit. I wrote it when I was in Detroit. And I didn't know I would be one day naming my book The Gift of Words. But this is it. get a little water here. I hope you are enjoying, and most of all, I hope you are inspired by the words that God has given me. People, I thought, and I'll share this in my book, but because I have the gift of words, and I always had dreams of, as a little girl from the time I can remember, my first dreams was that I was up in front of people speaking or doing something that had them clapping and shouting, and I couldn't believe that that was me. I would start running in these dreams because I grew up shy. This cute little girl, the people jumped on me all the time because I, quote, was pretty and all of that pretty stuff. And so I became kind of introverted because I didn't want people to know that I was so smart. Because it's like, you can't be pretty and smart. Everybody gonna hate you. So I went inwardly, and these dreams just kept coming more vividly as I grew older. I grew older and I grew older, that I would be speaking in front of somebody one day and saying something that moved them. I'm right here today, you guys, to show you that those dreams were not really necessarily dreams, but visions that God had given me to show me my evolution, what I would become to do one day, and that I would master words. And so, given that, I wrote this piece called The Gift of Words. The Gift of Words. I have been blessed with the gift of words, both the ability to write and speak fluently, intelligently, words that make people stand up, clap, shout, and say amen. Like E.F. Hutton, when I speak, people listen, give their undivided attention. Tune in to the words that I am saying. I don't have to yell, I don't have to scream. I just speak from my heart, be the voice of God. Therefore, I have to be careful how and when I use them. My words can soothe you, motivate, educate, and inspire you to think about your own life, who you are, how you are, and where you are. My words can make people sit up, look alert. The timbre in my voice always has a captive audience that pays attention and listens and clings to every word, like I'm a preacher, a teacher, a politician. My words, when spoken or written, are like a medicine that can cure and heal an aching soul. My words have the power to make you feel happy, healthy, complete, and whole. My words can pick you up and knock you off your feet. My words have the power to speak life or death into existence. My words can make you laugh, make you cry. My words can make you feel like you've been getting high from the stimulation of my spiritual conversations. But if you hurt me, break my heart, use or abuse me, my words become my weapons, my first line of defense. I can spit them so fast and crudely, like a murderer with an Uzi. I can spit words that'll make you wish I had shot you with a gun or cut you with a knife. My words can hurt you so bad you will beg me for your life. But you see, that ain't right. My words are my bond, my trust, my loyalty. My words are my blessing. And yes, sometimes my curse. Therefore, before I write or speak, I have to meditate and pray, be conscious and responsible how I use my words each and every day. I have the gift of words. My name is Amphra, and just so you know it, yeah, I am a conscious poet. Thank you. I love that piece. Love that piece. The gift of words. I'm not the only one with the gift of words. I had to go from being a shy little girl to saying, okay, God, what is it you want me to say? What is it you want me to do? What is it you want me to communicate? What is it you want me to appreciate? What is it about me that you chose me to give this beautiful gift of words? From someone who didn't want to speak up or speak out or let people use and abuse me all of my life, I couldn't do it no more. I couldn't do it no more, you guys. I had to be who I am or I was gonna die. And I say to you, be true to yourself, improve yourself, know yourself, love yourself so that you can live the life that God meant for you to live, because I am no different. I'm not special. God didn't choose me. I don't have favor over anybody. All of us have a gift. All of us have a gift. Use your gift. Operate in your gift. Your gift will make room for your life. I'm living proof of that. So thank you. Thank you so much. Let's see. Let's this is wonderful. Let's see. Got about 15 more minutes. Okay. Oh my. Gloria is clapping her hands. Thank you, Gloria Malone Bird. Thank you. Can't read that name. Leandra Palmer says, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Jamil the Diva says, love it. And Rain Right Across says, go, girl. Go ahead on. Thank you. Please share this video, you guys. It is important that we help each other. That is what Yams is about. That is what Amphora is about. It ain't about me. It's about us. It's about we. The next piece I'm going to do, I wrote this in 1997. It is featured in my first book, You Are My Sister, an inspirational book for women that promotes sisterhood and spiritual growth. Kay Cutter, if you're watching, he was 16 years old when he drew this cover for me. He's gone on to be a prolific director, writer, director, producer. Kay Cutter, he's watching today. Thank you, Sean. I call him Sean. His real name is Sean. I wrote this piece because up until I wrote this piece, this is how I lived my life for the first 30 plus years of my life. And when I wrote it and I performed it for a lady that I was working in, Ashley Stewart, and it was a sister that came in, a Caucasian sister, and she was a voluptuous woman, and she looked so just depressed and down because of her size. And so I read this piece to her and just wrote it like the night before, because it was a story of my life. And when I performed it for her, read it to her, and Ashley Stewart, who used to be in the Raleigh Springs Mall here in Memphis, she started to cry and said that that was her life. Since then, I've gone on to perform this piece. I've been told that it is so powerful that it's right up there with Maya Angelou's Phenomenal Woman. So I hope, sisters, you can relate to this piece. If you can't, God bless you. But it is called Someone Else's Eyes. And truly, it tells my whole life story in just a few words, you guys. Someone Else's Eyes. I know this one by heart. I wrote this sitting on the couch next to my mother, whom I love. She's no longer with us. But she had made me mad that day because she didn't support or believe what I was doing. She just wanted me to have a job, a good job, or get a man with a good job. That was her. That's all she wanted for me. That's all she, I guess, wanted for herself. And I just couldn't understand why my mom, who I knew loved me, but didn't have a insight that God had given me something better to do. And I had been trying to please her my whole life. So I wrote this piece sitting right next to her on her couch one day. It is titled Someone Else's Eyes. I get emotional when I do this piece. I've been trying to live my life through someone else's eyes. Trying to be what everyone else wanted me to be. Trying to please and satisfy their lives. Living my life through someone else's eyes. Trying to please my mother and father. Trying to be the perfect daughter. Trying to please and satisfy their lives, living my life through someone else's eyes, trying to please my friends. Yes, my friends, trying to be the perfect friend, sister, and lover. Trying to be the perfect girlfriend and mother. Trying to please and satisfy their lives. Living my life through someone else's eyes. Trying to be what everyone else wanted me to be. Trying to please and satisfy their lives. Living my life through someone else's eyes. Trying to please and understand my man. Trying to be the perfect shape and size. Living my life through someone else's eyes. Now it's time for Amphra to be the beautiful woman that God intended for me. No longer living my life full of lies. No longer living my life through someone else's eyes. Thank you. I don't live like that no more. I don't care what people think of me. I don't care if I'm the size you think I should be. I don't think if I'm doing the things that you want of me. I don't want to be in the box that you put me in that is meant for you. I no longer live my life trying to please anybody but my creator. Yes, I no longer live my life through someone else's eyes. It's a beautiful feeling when you don't care about what other people think about how you live. I live it according to what's divine and in line for me. All right. Thank you. Thank you. That was someone else's eyes. And I know a lot of women in particular, and I've learned that men too, we are taught to follow someone else's path, to try to be like somebody, be like this, do this, be true to yourself. Be authentic, be original, be who you are, be true to yourself and improve yourself constantly. That is what I do. That is what works for me. I can only be and know who I am. Yes. So, oh my God. Hi, Vanessa. She says, I can truly relate. Thank you. Beautiful. Thank you. Angela says, amen. Gloria says, awesome. Samantha, you forever changed my life. I'm glad to call you God, Mom. Thank you, Samantha. We're going to tell your story, Samantha. Yes, we are. My goddaughter, Samantha, is watching. You guys, she came into my life at such a pivotal point in her life. And we're going to tell your story, Samantha. You have a story to tell. Thank you, guys. We're about out of time. I have a couple of more that I'm going to do. I'll be back next Sunday to do part two of my live poetry. I hope you are enjoying it. I see people have shared it. Thank you so much. All of these words are copyrighted. They belong to me. I wrote them, or I let God give them to me, and I wrote them. I write in the inspiration of God. Let's see what I'm going to do now. We only have about 10 more minutes, and I'm going to play a little music at the end and read some more. Oh, I know, I have one more. Two more that I'm going to do. The other one I kind of I did a little bit show last year is also featured in my first book, You Are My Sister, an inspirational book that promotes sisterhood and spiritual growth. God gave this to me because, like I shared with you, I too have had an abortion in my life. It's nothing that I'm proud of. And while I am a pro-choice person still, but I believe that the pro-choice should be to make a better choice of who we sleep with in the first place. So this piece is prophetically entitled, A Message from an Unborn Child. Please let me be born into the world conceived of love. Be careful as you choose my name. Give me one that I'll be proud of. Don't let me be born into the world alone, not knowing my father because he's already long gone. Don't burden my life with your troubles and strife. Don't abort me and end my life. Don't abuse your body while you're carrying me. I don't need alcohol, cigarettes, or drugs. I need vitamins, nutrition, and lots of love. I don't need designer clothes and material things. Teach me to love, respect, and honor all human beings. Fill my life with strength and determination. I look forward to a higher education. Tomorrow begins a new life for me. I'm waiting to show the world that God has a purpose for me. So take care of me now, and tomorrow I'll do the same for you, because I am your future, and without me, there's no hope for you. A message from an unborn child. God gave me that peace, y'all. That's an emotional piece for me, because I have had an abortion. When I was young and dumb and didn't respect my own body, it took 30 years to get to this point. So I don't put anybody down for what they do to their bodies. But if we were taught to make the right choice, how to respect our bodies, how to love ourselves, how to choose better relationships, how to be who God intended us to be, the rise in abortions wouldn't happen, because we've learned how to make critical and conscious decisions. But unfortunately, religion, society, and community doesn't teach us anything about the empowerment of we, of us. And so here we are today. I read that we kill more babies than there have been men in wars that are born, you guys. So that's really touching to me, because that is my truth. I can't take it back, but I wish I had made a better choice in the first place. So we are about on time. We have 7 more minutes. Thank you guys so much. Hi, Vanessa, she says, I can truly relate. Beautiful. Thank you. Angela says, amen. That's beautiful. Thank you, guys. I got to give myself a minute here, because that piece, if I had known that when I had an abortion and felt that way and was this conscious, I would have 2 kids. But I only have Cameron, who has blessed my life, and he's watching today, and my son and my nieces and my nephews. But I still have that guilt. I still have that what if and why. But anyway, we are about out of time. So I want to do one last piece that God just gave me to write this in lieu of all of the coronavirus that's going on. I wrote it and I posted it one day last week on my Facebook page. God woke me up in the middle of the night, and I got up and wrote this piece, you guys. So really, I was just an instrument, honestly, because this was not on my mind necessarily. But when you are writing in the spirit and you learn to meditate and sit still and love the silence and the solitude and surrender, you'll hear the voice of God clearly inside. But we don't sit still. We don't unplug. We don't do anything to get back to creation, creativity, and our creator. So this last piece that I'm going to perform today, and I'll be back next Sunday to do some more, have a lot more beautiful stuff. But this is titled, A Message from God. Now that I have your attention, I need you to be still and listen. Put down your cell phones and all forms of technology. Reconnect to me and my creation. I've given you the power of the universe to live a long and healthy life on earth. I've given you the power to create your own health and wealth, the power to grow your own food, the power to love whomever you choose. I've given you the knowledge to take care of yourself, the power to create and reproduce life. I've given you the sun, the moon, and the stars. I've given you the seeds of the earth to plant, nurture, and grow your own fresh produce. I've given you the tools to harvest the fruit of your dreams, the knowledge to think for yourself, the wisdom to love, respect, and honor all living things. I've given you peace, joy, love, happiness, and compassion. I've given you the freedom to master your own life. Now, you no longer connect to me and my creation. You no longer sit still and listen to my directions. You no longer protect and respect Mother Earth. No longer grow your own food. No longer respect your own body. No longer protect your own mind. No longer respect your own soul. No longer connect and live in creation. No longer teach your children love and respect. No longer teach them responsibility. No longer teach them how to connect and play in the beauty of my creation. Now it's time to get back in touch with the gifts I've given you. Time to get back to creating your own health and wealth. Time to get back to the basics of family, love, and protecting the earth and the environment. Time to get back in sync with creation. Time to get in touch with the Creator. That is a message from God that He gave me the other day, you guys. This coronavirus is telling us to get back in touch, to take care of ourselves, to take care of the earth and the environment. You guys, we are destroying. We are in a world of self-destruction. We destroy everything and wonder where viruses, where sickness, where disease, where lupus, where cancer, where all of these things come from when we no longer live naturally of the earth that we came from, the dirt. Our bodies are of the earth. Our spirits come from the universe. We no longer appreciate or know how to do anything naturally. Everything is superficial. Love is even superficial today. Love is superficial. Our hair, our nails, everything we do, nothing is natural. We poison and self-destruct our lives and wonder, how did we get here in 2020 with this coronavirus? We ask ourselves why. This is a message from God. This is Amphra, and just so you know it, I am a conscious poet. Thank you, guys. Thank you. That is it for today. It's about 7:58. Thank you. Thank you so much. I will see you guys next Sunday with part two of Amphra, the conscious poet. Please share this video. My books are on sale. You guys can cash app me $10. There's $10 a piece in your address. I'll mail them to you. My cash app is $YamsTV. If you like a book, I have my t-shirts here. They're $20 each, you guys. Thank you for the love. Look at the love. Thank you guys so much. Hey, Benjamin, I love you. Benjamin Lewis, thank you guys so much for the love today, for sharing this video. I'm sharing with you who I am. I'm not perfect. I will never be. I like to cuss. Yes, I do. I'm going to do some comedy later on because you can't operate like this every day. You have to have balance in your life, and God gives us balance. He gives us nature. He gives us the power to think for ourselves and to create for ourselves, and that is what I do. So I do thank you. Let's see. So David Hines. Hi, David. Thank you guys so much. This has been wonderful. A fast hour. Look at the love. Thank you guys so much. Angela says, thank you. I enjoyed it. Thank you. Judy, oh, thank you, Judy in Detroit, my sister in Detroit. I love you so much, Judy. Thank you guys so much. Thank you guys. I'm going to leave today with another song as we close out today's YAM show, you guys. This has been wonderful. Let's see what I'm going to leave with here today. Let's see. let's see what I want to listen to. Thank you, guys. I have so much more to share with you. I will be hitting the speaking circuit once this virus is resolved. It's going to take a long time, you guys, for us to get back to normal, get back to nature, get back to natural, is what God has told me, to live our lives where we can get back to the earth that God has given us. So let's see what I want to listen to now as we close for today. Oh, let's see. I don't know what I want to do here. So I'm going to go back to what I started with. Be optimistic. That was so, oh God, I love Sounds of Blackness. So let's see. Okay, we're going to end today's show with what I started the show out with, and that is be optimistic. Thank you, guys.
The blackness, keep on.
Yes, share the video. to keep your head to the sky, yeah. As long as you keep your head to the sky, yeah. As long as you keep your head to the sky, yeah. Be optimistic, you guys. Keep your head up. Yeah! That's the show for today, you guys. Your head to the sky. As long as you keep your head to the sky, yeah. Give me the effort to come speak to your rep. Just contact me, I would love.